idea of recording a video is so fun. Until you actually press the recording button. And then it's like you're standing at the front of your class with a presentation. And you just don't want to do it anymore. It sounds fun. But also, suddenly I want to go home. I don't want to do this. It's so contradicting. That's anxiety for you. Well, I didn't want to create a whole intro or anything. I don't really know how to start this. I guess I just want to show off what I know. I'm Rabble Dabble. You can just call me Rabble. And I guess I'm just here to show you how to draw and shit. First, you'll probably just need a drawing program, and the one I use is Medibang Paint Pro. It's free on their website. I've been using it for like years. And yeah, there's kind of some talk about it, about how they want you to use other programs and pay for the benefits, but this one's free and it's decent. I use the Windows, obviously. I don't have a Mac. If you have a Mac, I'm sorry, you're screwed. I can't help you. I use Windows, it's pretty easy. I think they stop updating the 32 version, so I switched to 64. It's not really that much different. Not that much harder to download. You just click on it, pretty easy instructions, you just gotta download everything. If you have problems, you can find tutorials on the internet. It's just easy to figure out. Yes or no questions, like that, you know. It's pretty much the same on whatever version you download, too. Mobile. I haven't tried Steam. How the fuck do you draw on Steam? Anyway, I guess once you're done downloading that, you just open up the program. Yay! Now it's open. Oh god, there's ads. You don't have to worry about this. This just goes to Medibang's website itself. You just click X. Yay, now it's open. Oh my god, there's so many things. These? Just ignore them. They give you tutorials, ads, all this weird stuff. You just have to go over here. This is your profile. All the ways you can draw. You can post things too, although I don't really do that to Medibang's website. They give you a bunch of different settings, all the works. I'd suggest making an account. You might not want to give out your email so easily, but there's a cloud service. You can save settings, restore settings, you can save different artworks. It's a free service. You need to back up your works, all the things like that. Really, if you just want to start off, press Illustrate, and it creates a whole new image. I suggest going pixel by pixel, and probably 350 dpi. Just a white, solid color background. And then, you know, your width and height of your drawing. I suggest for going bigger. The bigger the width and the height for the picture, the better the resolution. I'm going to tell you that right now. If you draw small, if you draw on smaller pixels, whatever the heck, it's not going to come out as clearly. The bigger you go, the better it is. I usually go for 1300. I find that that's my most comfortable area, although you can go for like a very, very big canvas. It just kind of depends on how your computer can handle it. Just click OK. Oh my gosh, a new canvas. It's so beautiful. Now, there's a whole lot of stuff if you haven't seen this before. Usually there's a bunch of open windows on these two sides. I just exit out of them until I get the ones that I want. If you go up to window itself, you can actually see all of the different options you can have. So usually if there's brush settings, palette, previews, but like I said, I don't like all this clutter, so I usually just exit out of them. And you can adjust them too. Look, now I have color. You can adjust your brush sizes. Usually if you go one, that's like a single pixel, and the bigger you go, the better it is. I'm more comfortable with single or double digits for drawing. You've got different kinds of materials to draw with. There's a whole bunch of different brushes you can get from the service itself that are for free. You're allowed to personalize them as well. So say I go to my pencil, click settings, I can mess with the size, the pressure, opacity, the width, everything like that. I usually try to keep all the different settings and the different options. Lets you kind of mess around with them as much as you can. It's fun. Usually I'd be messing around with these markers. But I guess I'll start off with like a pencil, because that's probably what you have when you first start in. There's an option at the top here to have anti-aliasing on. And correction. So this is kind of new to understand if you're just starting out. The bigger the number you go, the kind of more correcting it will do. So say I do a simple line like this. That's the straightest line I can muster on this strength. But if I go somewhere higher, say like 31, it's an even straighter line. It kind of corrects where human error is. That way, if you're trying to draw lines that aren't super shaky like this, it just corrects it out. Obviously, you can see your color and such over here. You can press this little palette thing and it'll pop up with different colors. I usually don't try to go for black straight on, because black in art, just, it's too dark, I think. Like, to just go straight to the bottom, so I usually set it to like something just a little bit above. Try to make sure you go to your brush settings too. This is where I guess you'd make sure it works with what kind of tablet you have. You want to make sure that your pressure is working and everything. You can use these, or you can adjust it manually with your pressure sensitivity. As you can see, mine is already adjusted for the tablet that I have. I used to have a really bad tablet. I'd have to check this like every single time I open the app, because it just wouldn't work. Now, you can really just mess around with different settings and such. If you want to create another layer, you just go to the opposite side and click. Now you have two layers. Yay! You can also change their names and everything if you want to set certain effects, if you want to make it named a certain thing. If you need to layer them into different groups, there's folders, so that way, say if you have line art and you have a coloring layer, you can separate them into like different folders and whatnot. Makes it easy. And trash can's right there if you want to get rid of all of that, just delete. Now you're probably like, how do I export this thing? It's very easy. File. Export. Don't use this format. The second export, I'm guessing, is probably for more printing. The regular export is right here. Oh, wow! That's a lot of settings. This is fine. Usually you want to go with the PNG. These different options are really if you're doing like different things, like say if you were making a game or a sprite. you know, different options for different things. There's also transparency, but we'll worry about that later. Usually just go with your 24-bit. If you need your file to fit into a certain size, you can click the fits in the following size, kind of adjust the picture. Usually I don't do that because it'll export to whatever size you have it. So see right here, I'm in the 1300s. You can change the resolution if you want. I usually have it set to 350 dpi because that's, well, I think is the best. You can go lower or higher. I just usually go the middle route. These settings should automatically save, so probably just hit save settings, and these will be your normal export settings. You can change them every time you go to export. So it'll always pop up with this, but it'll always go on how you last exported it. So make sure if you're exporting them on different settings and stuff like that, you check to make sure it's the different setting and not the one you used last time. You pretty much press OK, and then it'll export as that. You'll be able to save a file. So see here, if I just save this blank canvas, pops up to all my artworks and whatnot. Saves as a PNG, or just write in the name, click save, it's that easy. Over here you kind of have all your tools and whatnot. You know, brush, eraser. This is a lasso eraser, really fun. All your shapes, you can move the picture around. You can use the bucket tool. We'll talk more about this bucket tool later, it's evil. But you have all the different options and tools that you're allowed to use. Really, if you hover over them, they tell you different things. I will warn you, probably try to make sure your brush and your eraser are on full opacity. Opacity is something you can mess around with when you have all your different tools, like I do have down here. You just want to keep the normal stuff on the full settings. Don't try to change it. It makes your life worse. Anyway, I guess that's really it for now. I don't really got anything else. I hope you liked this and it was easy to follow, and if not, well, I guess that's your problem. Sorry. I'm not sorry.